I thought it might be nice if we talked about some tech news. Would you like that?
God, Colton.
Woo!
This week, Arm unveiled a prototype for a plastic-based flexible microchip the company has creatively dubbed Plastic Arm. They've got to have some Germans on the naming committee over there.
It makes perfect sense.
Oh, yeah. We've seen bendy chips before, but not like this. With a 32-bit Cortex M0 CPU and with over 18,000 logic gates, Plastic Arm is about 12 times more powerful than the other flexible chip designs out there. They might as well be stickers. Which is one application for these chips, thanks to costing drastically less than rigid silicon-based chips. Plastic Arm could be built into product packaging or labels, which could, for instance, detect if food has gone bad. That's right, an ARM engineer said we'll be putting processors on lettuce or anything else you can think of. Ew, gross, that's what you thought of?
Nasty,
no, I'm not thinking of anything. I'm obviously not thinking. Good news for anyone with an RTX 3090 made by EVGA that was bricked while playing the new MMO New World, the company says they'll replace the busted GPUs for free. That's nice of them. Some are saying this is the least EVGA could do, since the prevailing theory is that the hardware was more to blame here than the game itself. Although Amazon has patched the frame cap in the game's menu just in case, I can't say I feel too bad for the victims here, since they made the choice to A, buy the most expensive gaming card on the market, and B, play New World. But why are we making fun of New World? It's not even out yet. Anyways, if you've been turned off of RTX 3090s forever, the Radeon 6600 XT looks like it'll be announced soon. So, you'll have an opportunity to make a more balanced purchasing decision.
Don't buy
choices.
Expensive things.
And more good news for the right to repair movement, the Federal Trade Commission has voted unanimously to create new policy enforcing customers' rights to fix items ranging from smartphones to farm equipment. The vote comes after US President Biden issued an executive order calling for such policy. And with any luck, this will lead to new laws preventing Apple and other companies from discouraging third-party repairs. Nice. Subscribe to Lewis Rossman. He talks about this stuff and his sassy energy is iconic.
Oh, he's gonna make funny.
Riley, wait, no! Why would you put that in there?
What do you mean?
Riley, wait, no!
Now it's time for Quick Bits, brought to you by Storyblocks and its massive library of stock footage, images, audio, and After Effects templates, which we use in almost every TechLinked episode, because what, you think we're made of cameras? That would be gross. Or weird. Storyblocks recently launched the Restock initiative to make content that more accurately reflects our world. So they've hired new BIPOC and LGBTQIA+ filmmakers to create authentic stock content depicting underrepresented communities. Storyblocks has affordable subscriptions with unlimited video and audio downloads, so check out Storyblocks today at storyblocks.com/techlinked.
Quick bits come, quick bits go. That's the digestive system for you. Many major websites and platforms, including Amazon, Steam, the PlayStation Network, and even Costco, experienced a brief outage yesterday thanks to a DNS issue experienced by major web infrastructure company Akamai.
Yep.
Did I pronounce that right?
Sure.
Beautiful. The issue was fixed after a few hours, but I don't feel comfortable using the web when everything can just disappear like this. So I'm gonna go back to reading books.
You don't read books.
I read books.
Do you?
Yeah, Atomic Habits by James Clear, just read it. I'm trying to become a better person, Riley.
Can I borrow it?
Epic Games has filed a new complaint in their lawsuit against Google, including new information about how the web giant tried to block Epic from hosting Fortnite on Samsung's Galaxy Store. Because while they're waiting for the Apple case to be decided, might as well just remind Google that they care, you know? You don't wanna leave them on read.
Red.
Fuck ya!
Zero.
Did I just swear? Sorry for swearing. Two Democratic senators introduced a bill yesterday that would remove Section 230 protections from social platforms if their algorithms are found boosting health-related misinformation, fueling more debate about the control that Twitter, Facebook, and the rest have over what people are and aren't allowed to say online. Like, I'm confused about things that I can say. Can I say fucking ding
dong? Stop it!
All right, sorry about that. Kaseya, the IT services provider to around 1,500 companies that were affected by a ransomware attack, has obtained a master decryptor key from a third party that is now being used to free the imprisoned data. Kaseya got the key after wandering around the dungeon for what felt like days until they saw a weird-shaped block that it turned out had to be rotated in order to get to the chest. A guide would have been handy in this case. And the Tokyo Olympics kicked off this week with a suitably Japanese musical fanfare from a ton of classic video games, including Dragon Quest, Final Fantasy, and Monster Hunter. You'd think there'd be some Nintendo titles represented, but nope. That company's probably too busy suing its fans for not wanting to pay $90 for a 10-year-old game.
Skyward Sword is $90 Canadian.
It's unbelievable. I want to play it, but I'm not paying that much. That's it. I'm done. Come back on Monday for more tech news. I promise we won't yell at you this time. It's just been a lot today.
Okay.
It's been a lot.
We're here for you.
Thank you.
No!
No!